Hey everybody, welcome back to the Silent Hill Homecoming playthrough. We've just arrived at the church. We are here to be blessed, I hope. Anyway, I don't know what we're doing here, actually. There was a medallion that there was a statue was holding down here. Let me see. We're supposed to give her something. I don't have a map, by the way. Here it is, the chalice plate. I think that if we exchange, perhaps give her this one. The statue is a her, because I think it is. But if we give the statue this plate, maybe we'll get the one that it's holding. Not sure. But anyway, thank y'all so much for being here. So happy to be playing this and just getting back into this playthrough with y'all. It's always so much fun for me. Always so excited. Okay, so this is what I'm thinking. I've got a chalice plate. Oh, really? Okay. Hey, question not your faith, but your devotion. It looks as though something is missing from this plate. Okay. So... Oh, hello. Oh my gosh. Give me that. I need to pay more attention. Holy crap. Wait, what did I just see? Oh, it's just that. Okay. But yeah, so we've gotten to this crazy church from the prison. That's right. And then we fought the asphyxia. Is that? I'm not sure if I'm saying it right. And we fought that boss, which was a whirlwind. That was the wildest boss, coolest design. Loved it. And it had something to do with Judge Holloway, because did you see her face? Her little smirk? Not to mention after she saw the locket, something made that monster manifest, I think. Same thing with the mayor, right? Was it the mayor? In the greenhouse at the hotel. So something I think is going on with that. I don't know yet. I'm excited to see what we're gonna uncover here. So since my plate chalice idea didn't work, and we did already search all this last episode, but... Ooh, by the way, look at that. Look at how it's like orange, the light. It's kind of nuts. Wow. Anyway, I forgot what I was saying. I got sidetracked. But let's go down here now and check into where I just unlocked this last time we played, and then I saved right there. So I have not gone past this point. Sheesh. Y'all hear that? Alright, let's read it.
Blessed is the man who does not tread the path of the wicked, or stand in the way of sinners, or sit in the seat of mockers.
Hmm. Or stand in the way of sinners, or sit in the seat of mockers. Interesting. Okay, I'm not sure which way I want to go yet. Looks like we can investigate that booth. This looks out of place. Unlit candle. Ooh, it's like blue. Hmm. Okay. Oh, hello. About the drink, sitting here all by yourself? Don't mind if I do. Ooh, sorry, chair. Yeah, so it does look like we investigate this. There appears to be someone inside. Maybe they know what's going on around here. Ooh, confessional
Forgive
time.
Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. It has been 4 years since my last confession.
Oh, okay. I'm the...
I don't blame you for ignoring me, Father. I'm not even sure you can help me. I'm lost. I'm so deep beyond the reach of my faith, and I'm sinking further away.
Oh. I wonder if this influences anything later on. I don't know if I should take it so aggressively. Let me just ask
what could you have done that was so terrible?
I took my role as a father, and I turned it into a daily chore. Fed him, cleaned him, put him to bed. I treated the dog with more respect. And when I was given a second son, the first might as well have been a stranger sleeping in our house.
I feel that you could start loving your son at any time.
I do love my son, Father. I love both my sons. But I had to make a choice. And the only way to live with that was to make sure my son never loved me. I had to make sure that he would never feel joy or compassion. All the things that make life worth living. You must understand, I was only trying to make things easier for him. And for me. And for this selfishness, I ask forgiveness.
If you truly want forgiveness, then you already have it.
Thank you, Father. And now I have something for
you,
Father.
Is that his
father?
I don't need anything.
Dad?
What?
Two sons. Wait. Two sons. Was that my dad? Kneeling man plate. I think it was because the voice. I was like trying to recognize the voice, and we heard the voice once before in Alex's attic. That's a big old candle. All right. I think that might have been my papa. So quiet now. I've got an unlit candle, a chalice plate, and a kneeling man plate. I'm loading up. I'm not messing around. Did it get darker? Or no, maybe it's just me. Hello? Did we do everything we needed to here? Yeah, we did. Okay, I'm scared. What's gonna be out here? I knew it, dude. I knew it, dude. Alright, I'm taking this one on. Oh crap, there's two of them. Holy crap, my ears! Alright, we can do this. We got this. I've been practicing. Get in there, Alex. Get in there. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, yeah. Uh-huh. One more. Okay, another. Come on! Woo! Alright, who's next? You next? Alright. I got this axe right for ya. It's got your name on it. Ouch. I'm gonna heal. Back up. Alright, now get in there. Woo! Get his butt! I countered. Or rather, I blocked. Holy god, just die. Lordy. Alright. Now that everything's under control, back to doing what I was doing. Which I can't help but feel something is gonna go down here. Because of the ceremonial dagger insert. I know that we must do something in here, though, with the statue. What's he looking at? What are you looking at, Alex? Oh! Yes! Awesome. Perfect. Alright. Great. This is just what I needed. Glad I paid attention to that this time. Wait a second, did I not see that before? The candle! Ooh. Drop. That was creepy cool. Okay. Candle goes there. I wonder what that means. Candle. Elle!
Elle?
God. Dude, we are... I feel like we are, like, gaining steam. Man, it's like this train is coming. Something is about to go down, and I'm so excited to see what it is, because I need more parts of this story. I'm already starting to understand that Josh was the favorite son for a reason. For the reason, I don't know yet why or what. But that's why Alex had been so shunned. And maybe Elle and Nora had the same thing. And something is happening with the kids being, like, offered or given some kind of choice the parents are making. And it's causing all this, I think. And I haven't really gotten any confirmation of that other than it's clear the parents were guilty, which in that makes me know that they're not innocent. So it makes me feel like they placated all this. Well, I don't know if placated is the word. Planned? I don't know. I'm just excited to see what's going on here. Hey, I remember that painting. That one in particular, on the left, the lady holding the bouquet. That was from the hotel. When we heard a lady, I remember she wanted me to help her put together her memories. Kind of sounded like my mom, but I'm not so sure. Listen to all the squelchy feet, dude. Stop it! I'm trying to read. Together, the three paintings form a scene of a man pursuing a mysterious woman. The middle panel depicts an ancient dying tree. Reminds me of the one in the hotel atrium. Ah! Oh, I can cut! What about this one? Oh! Oh! Hold up. I can't read right now. Dang it. I didn't get to read that. I was trying to just... Alex, wrong way. You gotta get this off your face now, buddy. Please get it off. Get that one off too. Oh my god. Come on, get him. There we go. Who's next? Oh, I see you over there. Anybody else? Oh, I missed. Dang it, can I read this about the man? I guess I'll read it when I edit, but... dang it. Oh well. Tree plate. Oh yeah, and all the tree symbology. Or symbology, what am I saying? All the tree... let me take care of this and I will continue my tethered thought there. You son of a... Dude, you are making my life difficult right now. There we go. Goodness gracious. Okay, sorry. Symbology is not the word. all the symbolism revolving trees. Trees typically are known to resemble family. So I can't help but feel that that's what it sort of is representing through the game. Do you remember in the graveyard there was the coins to put together? It was a tree. And then I think I saw a tree somewhere in like one of my items or... I don't remember now. But I had seen it somewhere else too. And it's just kind of... what's the word? Not suitable, but... I guess appropriate would be the word. It's sort of appropriate that we see it here in the church and we're learning so much about the families. Okay, this painting shows an alluring woman draped in luxurious silks. She looks vaguely familiar. Well, if he means familiar from, like, hotel, you know, then yeah, but if he's talking about, like, the woman in the painting, then I wonder what he means. It's a painting of a woman. She looks familiar, but I don't know where I've seen her before. Ooh, are they trying to depict this as, like, Dahlia or something? We know that the timelines are it's on like the same, it's like in the same timeline or the same universe, based on what W. Wheeler said about Sybil. Unless that was just pure Easter egg moment. But as I understand, it's supposed to be on the same timeline, same, I guess, universe. I think we're supposed to figure out which goes where here. But before I do that... Oh my gosh, so creepy. Dude, something's gonna freaking jump out at me. I know it. I just know it. Ooh. This is nice. Well, thank God. Hey, there's another one. It's a scene of a knight being stabbed in the back by an executioner. What did he do to deserve this? The center window has something just below it. Sword plate. Oh, sheesh! Holy God. Okay, you got me good. Uh-oh. Alright. Alright. You want some of me? Oh, God. Okay, what I said earlier, I was kidding. Alright. We got this. We got this. No worries. We just gotta maybe get away from him and wait for an opening. No. No. Crap. I'm trying to get around them. I know I could do this. Alright, just kidding. Alright, this is gonna be tough. I don't think I'm gonna be able to get behind them unless I, like, physically dodge. This is gonna be nuts, actually. Very difficult. Come on. Keep that going. Shoot, they keep turning towards me. I might have to get out the axe, but I really want my 9 bullets to go straight to the back of one of these. Ouch! Oh, there we go. Ha ha ha! Alright, the other one's mad. Alright, I admit I ate that one right to the face because I was in combat stance and I'm trying to open up my inventory. There we go. Alright, we got this. One more. I even have a shotgun. Youch. Got it good, but at what cost? Oh. Alright. That was a long haul, but I made it. I was really trying to put all of my bullets to use, and I did not want to just shoot it head on. I was like, come on, we can get behind it. Just took me a little while, but... Oh, hello. All right, looks like we might have to find another way. Thanks for sticking it out through that one, y'all. That was brutal. We do this, maybe? Oh, cool. Great, I was just thinking, don't make me drop all the way down and have to go all the way back up, but thankfully, it set us up nicely. So now we put the corresponding plates, I guess, with the corresponding segments, sacrifice, sorrow, desire, vengeance, penitence. Okay, let's see if we can figure this out. We've got a sword, a tree, handle, kneeling man, chalice. Alright, well, let's start. Whoa. Did it just do it all by itself? I was thinking it should go where penitence was. And it did. Alright, I guess I don't think we have to figure this out. I think it does it on its own. Can we go back? Vengeance. That would probably be sword. Okay. did it say? Desire. That would probably be the tree. I don't know. Fire makes me think of desire, but I don't think the candle would be it here. Let's do candle. Let's do candle. It's fire. Okay, sorrow. I don't know. Chalice? Wait. Sacrifice. No, this is not right. Sacrifice might be the sword. Let's just go back and see what it says. Okay, I'll take that. Wait. Alright. We know the kneeling man, penitence, that's gotta be it. Right? That has to be. Vengeance. I feel like that would have been the sword. Can't be the tree. I guess the candle for vengeance. Desire is the tree. Sacrifice is the sword. Okay, go back. Did it work? It didn't work. What was this one again? I can't take it. It won't let me take it. Alright, it's not letting me have it back. I don't understand. It won't let me take it. I'm trying. Oh, I got it. Okay, sorrow. Would sorrow be the kneeling man, perhaps? No. What if that's the candle? I feel like I should be so good at this, but for some reason, I'm not getting this one. Okay, I'm gonna stick with desire being candle, because it's like a flame, I guess. Vengeance only makes sense that it would be the sword. This has to be the kneeling man. Penitence has to be. Sacrifice. Okay, so the reason I thought penitence was a kneeling man, because I thought it was sort of penitence meant when you are repenting for your sins. So I thought it was like a moment of like where a man is like before God and like, you know, kneeling, praying, like in this sort of position of repentance. That's what I thought it meant. But and it's similar, but it simply means a realization of one's misdeeds, I think. So with that in mind, I think sacrifice might be the kneeling man then, maybe. So vengeance. I still feel like it's gotta be this. In the places where we found these, it gives you kind of a clue, I think, because in the picture depicted in the stained glass, when we picked up this sword piece, he was getting stabbed in the back. That doesn't necessarily depict vengeance, but vengeance is thought of like hurting someone, right? So, or getting back at them. So, I don't know why I feel like this has to be that. Desire? The only reason why I think it's the candle is because fire, flame means like, it's like the symbolism of like passion and love and desire. Exactly. So, and the place where we found this one. Oh no, I'm getting it confused. The tree was where we found that one. Yeah. We got this candle one somewhere else. Where did we get the candle one? I can't remember. Okay, anyway, I'm gonna stick to it. And sorrow. Would that be the kneeling man? I don't know. I feel like I need to know biblical references in order to get this. And this is penitence. Okay. I gotta say, I am actually just completely stumped. And I know when I'm editing my own playthroughs, I'm looking back at myself and I'm just like, It's so easy. Like, you know, once I know and I've seen it and I'm aware, I'm just like, how could I have not seen it? So y'all are probably screaming right now at your screen. I'm so sorry, but it is what it is. I'm completely stuck. So here's what I think. I think I need to step away from the things that I think I know, which I think there's a world where vengeance is the sword. And I'm just going to tear that away from my brain. Tear it away. Let's think about in the realm of Silent Hill. Let's not think about the symbolic meaning of objects in the real modern world. Let me try to think of it in like the lore and the story. And let's stay away from vengeance right now. Let me try to figure out the other ones, like desire. Even though I think that's the candle, through and through, like I feel like you can't convince me otherwise. Let's just entertain, okay? I'm gonna open my mind, okay? I'm really gonna try this again, okay? Summoning, solving energy, okay? I'm just really gonna tear away everything I think I know, and let's just think of it like Silent Hillian. Let's work this Silent Hill degree. theoretically, that we earn when we play these games. So, let's think of it this way. Where did we find all these pieces, right? Like, wasn't that woman that we found? There was a statue of a woman, right? And she seemed to be crying, right? I thought, I don't know, she seemed kind of sad. And I think that's where we got the chalice. Or no. That might be where we got the flame, the candle one. Yeah, that is, actually. But she was holding, there was a chalice at her feet. Now I'm trying to, like, relive it. There was a chalice at her feet. We gave her the candle. Which then she gave us, which one did she give us? Not the tree. I think she gave us the chalice one. But I don't know why that would make me think that's sad. Why did I think that? Okay. Let me think back at this statue. There was a plaque on her statue, right? Didn't it said something about sorrow, didn't it? Is that where I'm thinking? Then I would imagine, because we gave her the candle. I don't know why that, I feel like that's what would go. Desire. Okay. Now this one, I remember. We found it in front of the painting with the woman with the bouquet. Alex said she looked familiar, remember? So if desire, that's where we found... It talked about desire, right? Didn't it? It said something about like a woman and a man desiring one another in the middle of between the tree, right? Where the tree was between them. So that's where we found this. So that's why I feel like the tree would be that, right? If we're thinking Silent Hillian here, right? Not what a tree actually represents in modern day, which I think it represents family. Okay, and then what was the one? Vengeance. Okay. Alright, so let's not think about the sword. When we got the vengeance, or when we got the sword plaque, it was at the moment where the man was getting stabbed in the back. Either that sacrifice, because someone said, or Alex said when he read it, he said, what did the man do to deserve this? So what if that sacrifice? What if the sword? I mean, that kind of makes sense, but okay. Well, let's just say that. Now, the vengeance one, where the heck did we get? I'm just going to do this. Because I don't remember how we got the other two or where we got them. Dang it. I was really, really working that case, y'all. I was working that case hard. I wish we could go back. That would be so helpful if I could go back. Wait. Our journal. Okay. It looks like a baptismal font. There's something floating inside, but I can't quite make it out. The chalice plate. So it said there was something floating. I can't quite make it out. That was like a body. It was like floating in blood, pretty sure. The door to the confessional is locked. There appears to be someone inside. I got... the kneeling man plate. Yeah, look, the expression on the statue is one of sadness. It looks like it's holding on to something. Candle! Oh my gosh, why didn't I read this 20 minutes ago? This painting shows an alluring woman draped in luxurious silks. She looks vaguely familiar. It's of a man being restrained by the roots of the tree. Okay, okay, yeah. His eyes are fixed on the woman. Dude, the tree is desire. The tree is desire. Okay, stabbed in the back by an executioner. An executioner would be someone sought out or paid to kill someone if they did something wrong. So maybe the sword plate would be penitence. Okay, I'm so glad I read my notes. Give me this, give me all. Penitence, sword. Yeah, because it said in my notes, the executioner. And we've read in our notes, executioner was the one carrying out the discipline, right? So I feel like that's the sword, because that's where we found it. We found the sword plate in front of the depiction of the stained glass, okay? And because of that statue saying it had sadness in it, where we picked up the chalice, or the candle, yeah. That's why I feel like it's gotta be the candle. And then sacrifice. Sacrifice makes me think it would be the chalice because we found a body floating in the baptismal font where the chalice plate was found. That's why I think that, okay? And then desire. The paintings depicted desire. The roots of the tree were holding the man back. And we found this piece in front of it. Okay? So this has to represent it. Please, Silent Hill gods. No! There's no way! I did my dues, y'all. I did my dues. Come on. There's no way. Look. Okay, we got sacrifice wrong. We know desire is right, and we know the candle is right. Okay, it's based on the notes. Look at the notes. There's no way that we're wrong there, okay? So we just need to figure out the sword. Scene of a knight being stabbed in the back by executioner. Then maybe that's vengeance like I thought all along. And the chalice, I still think the chalice might be great in the penitence section. And this door, the door to the confessional is locked. There appears to be someone inside. Kneeling man plate. And the kneeling man was the one asking for forgiveness. So maybe then it's this, and maybe vengeance is... Yes! Yes! I'm so happy! I just had to think about... Oh no, dude. That's my dad. No, I need to save. No way, dude. Come on. Okay, we have no choice, y'all. We have no choice but to keep going. And my mouse is clipping outside of the actual game. I need to restart the game, basically, to make this clipping error stop. Basically, my mouse is running off the screen, so when I click somewhere, it clicks out of the game, and I'm so worried that... Anyway, the problem is I'm just worried about going further without saving. But I'm just gonna have to... just keep that in mind if we have combat. That's all I'm trying to say.
Alex? What are you doing here? I'm here to save Joshua.
Yeah, where is he? And why are Joshua, you...
You can't save him. You need to get out of here.
Aww.
Stop giving me orders, man. You have no idea what I'm capable of. You hate me. It's okay. I don't blame you. I don't hate you. I forgot you. A long time ago. I never knew cemetery too, son. I had to make a choice. And now I'm paying for it. We all are.
So he had to choose Alec, or Josh, for whatever reason.
After all I've done, you still wear my old dog tags.
Aw, really?
That must mean something.
Aww.
What are you talking about?
Oh.
These are mine. I'm a soldier.
He didn't just even know it was his.
Alex, you've been in the hospital.
What?
I know. I was wounded in battle.
Oh, that's what we saw in the beginning.
A mental hospital. You've been there ever since the accident.
No. That's not true.
No.
I'm a soldier. I protect people.
We had to take you there. After that night. After I gave your brother this.
What? What night? What happened that night?
What is this thing? What did you do? Where's Joshua?
Oh my God. Dude, so if this is in this universe, this representation of this monster whom we identify as Pyramid Head, but they're identifying him as the boogeyman in this universe. So with being true to that, he was like the executioner. So he is like, he's slashing down anyone who's going against, I guess, the will or the reign or the way of the cult, right? So if he's slashing down his parents, then well, his dad, then yeah, his dad definitely did something bad. But more importantly, I don't know what his dad did yet, other than he said he had to make a choice. More importantly, what is he saying to us? What did he just say to Alex? He just said that Alex was in a mental hospital. And the only reason why I can draw that would be true is because in the beginning of the game, it was like a dreamlike sequence, right? And I don't know what the accident was, but he was kind of yelling like, where's my platoon? Where's my people? Where's my men? Like, I thought it was a military accident and he was being rushed to a hospital, but he was like kind of in and out of it or something. But if he had an accident and he's recalling it that way, and if he wasn't in the military at all, what? There's no way he was never in the military. That's exactly what his dad was trying to say. Am I understanding that correctly? That he went to a mental hospital? I mean, my brain just got blown. That was crazy. And he said the accident happened after we gave Josh this, which we saw when we earned our first Silent Hill degree in symbol rearrangery. We solved the crest. Oh my gosh. Dude, his poor dad though. Like, what did he do to deserve that? What is going on? Ooh. Okay, I gotta say, the way that was done though was really, I loved the tension there, and I loved that was just really, really intense moment, and it was playing with like Alex's reality, which was really neat, and it messed me up too. Now I'm like, what? Like, I need to know the truth. I am Oh my gosh, I need a save point because I have to restart the game. It's truly messing up my mouse right now. I have to turn to the left to keep the mouse on the screen, if that makes sense. Hey, look, what is this? Mining equipment. Doesn't look like it's been used in a while. The suit could protect me. What? Oh, because we're going down? Oh my god, I'm in a freaking suit. I look like a cult member. What? This is crazy. I have never seen an ounce of this. Oh my gosh, I'm so scared if I get into combat. I'm gonna like... See how my mouse is doing that? You can kind of see it. It's like... You can see it's going to the edge of the screen, but... What I see is I see my mouse of my computer. And it's like way, way off, so I'm having like a clipping issue. Okay. We're just gonna have to make it. I'm gonna have to make it to a save point. Hopefully soon. So I guess we need this to protect our lungs from whatever is burning. This is nuts. Like, where are we even going? Below the church? This is wild. Oh! Why are you staring, looking all creepy? What if I didn't put this on?
Like a job, soldier. I love what I do. Fixing things. It's my gift. But now, I have direction.
Is he gonna confirm things that Alex like forgot? Son of a...
Don't you agree, soldier?
Is he mocking us? I think he is. Oh no, I hope the game doesn't crash. Okay, we're good. Woo! There's always that moment before the loading. Oh my gosh, this is nuts. I'm really intrigued though. I'm living for this mystery. I really got chills when he said, no, you weren't, or how did he put it? You weren't in the military. You went to a mental hospital. That really blew my mind. And where is this mofo taking me right now? He's about to learn what I've...
Judge Holloway.
I knew you were suspicious.
You should probably call me Margaret. You're so grown up now.
I found Elle. I don't know what happened. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry too. You try so hard to raise a child, to instill your values into her. You want her to be her own person, but you hope she'll always remember what's important. Family.
Going on?
Family is the most important thing, Alex. I would do anything to protect them. That's why I sacrificed my daughter.
What?
What? Nora? Oh, wait.
Founders.
Elle?
They had good intentions. They left the order to start a new life in Shepherd's Glen.
Oh.
But they feared the wrath of our god. So they made a pact to keep us safe. All that was required was a small sacrifice.
What? No.
Once every 15 years, founding families must make an offering to appease the god. One of our children, our own flesh and blood, struck down by her own hands.
Oh, so he killed her. The parents.
I watched the light fade from Mom's eyes as I took her life. No.
Dr. Fitch.
Protect our family.
Judge Holloway.
Protect Shepherd Glenn.
And now Josh has to go.
One of us failed. Lacked the strength to fulfill his duty.
Your
father.
That's why he got punished.
Where's Joshua?
Oh, his dad said no.
Don't you see? Because of him, our sacrifices were in vain.
Don't bring your smoke towards me.
Our God was broken. Your father's lack of conviction cursed us all. We must revive the order which our founders abandoned.
By kidnapping? By murdering?
Murdering? I've given them life to rebirth.
Wait.
And what about Elle?
Are they saying all the kids?
Her too?
I tried to make Elle understand. But she's like you, Alex. She still thinks there are such things as good and evil. But there aren't. There is only chaos and order. Show my daughter the price of your disobedience.
What did she do? She didn't do nothing. Why is this guy like her lackey or something? I guess because he's a part of the town. He wants to be safe too. He wants his pact to work out. What are you gonna do with that?
Don't! Look! I can help you with all this.
Oh, she just wants to kill me right now.
Way.
No, thanks. It's time I finished what your father called.
No, dude. Oh my gosh, I'm in game. What? Dude, this is insane. This is supposed to be QTE, I can tell. But I'm playing the mod, so it does it for me, but I'm clicking just to make sure. Oh my god, YouTube, can I even show this?
Oh. It's finished.
Alex. Okay, hold on. I gotta save because I gotta restart the game, but I'm gonna keep going. Hold on. Okay, reloaded my game. Mouse is not rolling off the edges anymore and it's clipping properly. Woo! We just got a lot of information right there. So Judge Holloway is straight up like, first of all, she's dead. Holy crap, that was intense and so strange without the QTEs. Aside from that, she just straight up gave us the entire, I guess, plot line of what's going on. So a pact was made because the founders didn't agree with the order, so they wanted to separate themselves from the order. So they went on, started their own town, which totally makes sense now, by the way, that a pact had to be made. So I thought something had to happen with some kind of deal, perhaps, with the kids. I don't really know how I piece that together, But now I'm like, of course they said if you want to separate, you got to make a deal to protect the town from, did they say their god? I think that's what they said. And that's why they had to give their children. Did it say every certain amount of time? I think it did. And so the mayor, I couldn't really see how he killed his son. But I saw something like earth and like he was shoveling. So did he bury his son alive? That would explain maybe the boss, why it looks like a root or something. I don't know. Anyway, and then she, Judge Holloway, I thought I saw her strangling. So is that why the boss? Someone had commented that. Someone said that it was more creepy about, what's creepiest about the boss is that Alex removed its hand so that it could breathe air to die. Which is like totally like freaking plumb opposite of how Nora died, if that's indeed how Judge Holloway killed her, by strangling her so that she could, that makes sense to the boss's name. Oh my god. Asphyxiation. Holy crap. Okay, so wait, what about the other boss then? There was one more. What was the other boss we fought? Oh, Scarlet. Okay, so did he cut her up or something? I'm not really sure how Scarlet died. Y'all have to let me know. But what we do know is the pact, the agreement, is not working right now. And I don't know what that means for Shepherd's Glen yet, but the reason it's not working right now is because both Alex, apparently, and Josh now live. Because his dad couldn't do it. So that's why his dad was cold to Josh, because he just felt like he had to be, since he was choosing, or do I have it backwards? But wait, who is supposed to be the sacrifice then? I understood it as like Josh was, they'd like hamper him and love him, I don't know. And then, but to me, if you're asking me, it makes more sense that you would shun the one that you're supposed to sacrifice, right? Because you don't want them to like, I don't know. I have no idea. But, I mean, I am under the impression that Josh was supposed to be the one. Ooh, Lair map. Oh. Lair, huh? It said that we were like underground, I think. Face mask. There's duct tape. Hey, we got the ceremonial dagger. Ooh, what's this tome? I can't access it. Looks really cool though. Okay, wow. She did. Judge Holloway lied to us all. I'm glad she's dead. Yeah, man, she gave me some really big Dahlia energy. Like, she was the lady leading all this. Alright, we've already saved. We're good to go. Holy crap, this has been insane. And the crap that's happened with Alex, like, so is he actually insane and has forgotten a part of his past? And that's why he was drawn here or drawn back home to try to remember? Did he serve at all? I mean, the store's locked, but can be opened quickly. Thank God for that message. That's nice. So, I wonder if his dad is right. I mean, it seems like his dad wouldn't lie right there. On his, like, deathbed, so to speak. Oh my gosh, we only have the dagger and the ring. Hello? Holy moly. Let's go back before we continue down this way, because there's a lot more. I just want to make sure that I kind of search the easier areas. Oh my god, what is happening in there? Is that... Oh! What? What? Who said that? Oh! I will stun lock you. I will stun lock you. I can't see because the door's in the way, but I will terminate you in any way possible. Yeah, that's right. What you gonna do? Nothing. Nothing. You can't even touch me. Oh my gosh, that's so creepy. You can hear their voices through their masks like a radio. Whoa. Wait, who is this? I got a steel pipe. Classic. Whew. Is this a deputy of Shepherd's Glen? Or, well, a cop? My god, what is going on? Okay, we need to go the other way. It's jammed. Break. Oh! I'm sorry. I'm just scared. Come here. I got this. I got this. Well, you want some of this? Look, you're in the corner now. What are you gonna do? Nothing. Oh, okay, I see you. I will beat you to death with this pipe. Come here. Whew. Okay, maybe I should go back where I was. Look at this, we're finding all kinds of things. The key. This key could get me into the next wing. Oh, I know where the door is. Okay. Got it. Shotgun ammunition. Holy crap. Through the Fog, A Skeptic in Silent Hill by Paul Shh. Hey, that name sounds familiar.
Silent Hill, a town known for its mysterious happenings and now defunct cult, The Order, which was recently exposed by Detective Douglas Cartland.
Douglas?
But what darkness really lies behind the simple veneer of the sleepy town? Paul Scheibel's latest book chronicles his research during a 2-year stay in the town, including detailed interviews with longtime residents, cult documents you won't find anywhere else, and an appendix of popular local legends. As expected, life in Silent Hill is far more mundane than you might have heard, than you may have heard. And the great evil the Order sought to find originated from the same abyss whence all religions spring. Nowhere darker than the fanatical minds of its followers.
Ooh, so they're basically saying that from their research, that all this came from their crazy minds. But we know it's more real than that. This paper lists more people they brought here to torture.
By a decree of the ordained council, the following have been chosen to serve the will of our divine lord: James L., Tony E., Justin H., Ryan N., Anna L., Matt N., Jeremy E., Sarah R., Jeffrey E., Roger J.
Should we recognize any of these? I don't recognize them, but they're just people, I guess, of the village, or the town, Shepherd's Glen, I guess. Or of Silent Hill.
Do not make any mistakes. Remember the penalty for not following the word. All repent, for our kingdom is near. A.S.
A.S. Ooh. Oh crap. It's another drawing. So do not cry aloud at night. Stay hidden in your bed, or the boogeyman from Silent Hill will come and chop off your head. Holy crap. Waste of time. It's locked. Okay. Locked. Need to find another way. Okay, so let's go back to that long corridor. What's up with this hall? Dude, loving this track right now, though. Okay, I think we can go this way. And let me check this door. Broken. Alright, now I feel more confident to go through here. We should go here, but let me check this first. Oh, Y'all scared the heck out of me. He said he was gonna cut me up. Oh. You don't even know. Sucker. Come here. What? Oh, you talking smack? Come here. This is my town now. That's right, your buddy next. Yeah, let's go. Got a pipe too? Well, guess what? Mine's better. That's right. It's unlocked. Oh, I know he's mad. Okay, that got me good though. They've got the jump scares laid out really well. Wow, what a weird looking pane around that. Jesus, what about this one? Okay, both locked. Any items in these bins? What's that? Oh, I thought it was an item. Oh, hey, okay. What? I'll need some help with this. Oh. We might get Elle. Okay, I see. Did I check the end? It said there was a door here. This isn't going to open. Okay, let's go to the door. Oh my gosh. This is nuts. The way everything's going down right now. Okay, key time. Got it. Sector 3, key. Oh yeah, I can. Oh no, you're not. Come here. Alright, I can do this all day. How about a hard hit?
I don't like this man.
Oh. What did he say? No, say what you said. What were y'all saying? He said, I don't like this man. Something, something. I'll have to read the text when I edit. Y'all don't even know, man. Y'all don't even know what I've been through.
I'm gonna turn you up.
Oh my god, they're really creepy, actually. Alright, I got this. No problem. No problem. We'll just keep this going. Whew, he tried to get away. Okay, hold on. I gotta check all of these. One more. Okay. Yeah, okay. So it looks like we can go through that. Okay, I'll remember that. 301 is locked. Okay. We checked this one, didn't we? Yeah. It won't budge. Dude, no, we have to save her. Are you kidding me? They're not gonna do this to us. Why are they killing us this way? Like, so brutally. That in the beginning.
You had a choice.
What do we gotta do? Oh, let's go, Alex. Let's go. You're so good, dude. You're so good. Push. Push. All right. That's good. Cry. Get in there. That's right. Oh, we gotta get through there, though. Oh, crap. Now we have to fight him. He looks crazed.
You're going down.
Listen, I told you, don't mess with my girl.
Alex. Mother.
I'm sorry, Elle.
Oh, God. I can't believe this.
We gotta get you out of here. Come on.
God, imagine that. Like, you killed your girl's mom. My gosh. Okay, hold on. Can we go back in there? Is there anything? Oh, thank God I decided to come back here. There's that book again. But this time we can read it. It looks like a doctrine describing their faith. It reads,
"Every child born of the flesh bears the filth of the flesh that created it. The lives of our unpure are steeped in filth, and their deeds and words spread filth through the world. Even death is not enough to cleanse generations of this filth from the flesh. The only way to ensure these poor souls can live pure lives is to cleanse the flesh from their bodies."
Oh, that's why it's, like, so brutal. Like, they're... That's why when I was wondering, like, why are they murdering us this way? It's almost like they have to inflict the most violence on our... on their skin. Like... my gosh. That's why Dr. Fitch was doing that. Alright, what else is in here? Why is it purple, by the way? I don't know if it's my version of the game. The PC version, or... So we're in some sort of, like, warehouse, I guess? Okay, I just wanted to make sure I had collected every item possible. This is decent. 4 health drinks, 2 first aid kits. Alright, we gotta do this. Actually, I think I have to climb over. Maybe. Or she climbs under. And then she helps me open it. I'm so glad she's alive, though. I would have been really upset if they would have killed her. I mean, the game's not over yet, so we'll see. But we'll see what happens, because I think... Oh, sorry, my light went out again. No! Okay, light is back up and running. Let it charge a little bit, so we should be good for the rest of the episode. I know this episode is running a bit long, but... it's just because I was so excited and I really wanted to go through to the end, I think, for this one. It was just getting good and I
let's
was just...
go!
Oh, yeah, Alex! Let's go! And I just really wanted to get here to this part. It's the end of the end. I think there's a,
piece
of me.
He's got a gun. Is he good? Yep. All right. Switch targets, please. Oh, God. Okay.
Uh-huh.
They cussing at me? They don't even know. They about to get it. Both of them. Yeah, uh-huh. Who's next? The sound effects are great. Oh my gosh. Whew. We did it. Where's Elle? Where did she go? Oh, there she is. Okay. Alright, we're good. We got the key now. I think it goes here. Oh, we have to access it from our inventory. Wait a second. We used the key earlier. So what are we missing then? Hey, there's a room. Okay. We missed the room, didn't we? Actually no, we don't get there from here. Excuse me? Through here, I think. Yeah. Okay, we go around here. Take a left, and there should be a room that we missed. Okay, let's go this way. This one. Oh, dang it. Oh, I was mistaken. It's this one. Oh, they're both locked. Hmm. Then where do we get this said key? Hmm. Let me go check. Where did Elle go? Oh, there she is. Where did we miss a key? Is there any... Oh, never mind. I was just about to say. I bet... Well, maybe not. Let's go through here. I kind of think that maybe with Elle now, we can access another section that I thought I recall a wheel being at. Which would be down here. Where did Elle go? These guys are freaking hateful, man. Okay, we'll just do this all day. Okay. We need Elle. Come on, girl. If I'm not mistaken, it's straight ahead. Yeah, here we go, here we go. And we're gonna let her through. Then she'll be able to let us through. Hopefully, if nothing happens to her. Go, go, go. Okay, perfect. Whew. Some of these sounds I hear in the background. Do you hear them right now? Those. They sound an awful lot like the sounds used in Silent Hill 3. I'll have to look at the exact moment. Hey! We got a rifle! Finally! Nice. Any notes for us? Shotgun ammunition? We don't have a shotgun yet. But I have a feeling we will find one. Oh my god, we're getting littered with drinks. I have a feeling it's about to go down then. Oh, no, dude. Hold on, I gotta read this. It's a set of bylaws for how to live by the Order's system of beliefs.
One, commitment. All members of the Order must have fully committed themselves to this purpose in their beliefs, their activities, and their lives. Membership. Membership within the Order is extended to all that seek the old ways. A. Levels of membership. Mother Circle. The Mother is considered the founding group of the Order. The name of the founding group is the Mother. B. Daughter Circle. Any second generation group hived off of the Mother. C. Servant Circle. Any third generation group stemming from the Mother. The High Council. The High Council is set in place as a tool for all within the Order to make use of. The purpose of the High Council shall be to aid in the process of group formation as needed, act as a governing body in matters pertaining to the Order as a whole, and to be a judge slash jury if asked to settle disputes.
So they literally were responsible for their own governance. And they had like a series of, I guess, hierarchy to like their level of governance. Like they actually had people of different governing authorities within. So at least in this game, we're getting to see like a lot of that structure.
Grievances and discipline procedures. All decisions made by the High Council are binding. Presenting your case before the council implies your acceptance of their decision. Those seeking mediation must contact the scribe. The High Council shall be called in to preside over disputes within a group to hear complaints and accusations of inappropriate acts, abuse of power by leaders, and any other complaints that are deemed worthy to preserve the public image or internal integrity of the Order. B. The nature of the disciplinary action shall be decided at the sole discretion of the High Council. These actions shall contain, but not be limited to, assignment of manual labor, persecution of an individual member, banishment of an individual member, and banishment of a group. C. If an individual member wishes to leave the order, they are required to bring the request to the High Council.
Huh. And they probably don't make it out. Do they? Okay, let's keep checking the rest of these rooms. But I guess... actually, yeah, I'm heading in the right direction. But hold on. Let's check and make sure. I see him. Okay, I just want to make sure that there were no items and that everything was locked in here. Do you know? There's no way he's alive. Dude, he'd be dead. Oh. What? Dude, a medkit is not gonna save him, but we're gonna do it anyway, of course. You gonna make it, bud? Elle. I hope he makes it. Oh.
You need to get him out of here.
Wait.
What about you?
I thought he died. Whew. Okay.
I can't. Not without Joshua.
Be careful. I can't lose you too.
Oh. Ooh, that's creepy. Oh man, making me all emotional. Ugh. 107, let's check that out. Locked. Hearing crazy stuff. Hey, I'm hearing that bell. The water. That sounds like a boat, yeah. Like I'm on a ship. Broken. Wait. That looks like where we're supposed to go. Oh, thank God I checked over here. Oh my God, it's all happening, y'all. I'm so excited. Okay. I didn't find a shotgun back there. Hold up. I kinda wanna... Hold on. Wait, this is locked. We never found a key, did we? Yo, I need to find that key. I bet you the shotgun's in there. No, I'm not going forward without it, dude. Dude, no. I'm not. It's got to be... I don't have it, do I? I just have the freaking ring. No way, man. I'm going back. I'm gonna find this freaking key to this room. Wait, can I not go back? I can't, can I? We're past the point of no return, aren't we? We are. Oh, man. Big oof. I really thought that we were gonna keep going a little bit. Before it was just end game. Dang it, I bet you what's in there is the freaking shotgun. I did not find a freaking key. I want to replay this game so bad. This is bonkers because I look everywhere for things. They're really good at hiding stuff. I will give them that. Whoa. Oh my god, are these like the phonetic? These are like the phonetic portions and other symbolic representations of the halo of the sun. Like this bug right here? That's like part of like a phonetic sound in the Hungarian alphabet, if I'm remembering my research properly. Now the others I don't recognize, but I do recognize the eye. That represents like the all-seeing eye of God. The scales, I kind of remember those. Oh, and this, yeah, this symbol right here, that's like the bottom of the halo of the sun. That right there kind of represents like a demon because of the pitchfork. The eye is at the top. Oh my gosh, we're about to get this in a bag, but hold on a second. It's a tablet etched on the wall. It appears to be written in a strange symbolic language. Hmm. It doesn't say anything else about it. Okay. Hey, our dagger should be used there. Okay, this is probably the control for it. And it probably opens up that door. And that's where we came from, right? Oh no, wait, that... Okay. Over here. We didn't come from here. Oh, it's locked. Okay, makes sense. So, it's a huge, heavy door. I can feel heat from the other side. The door is protected by a strange lock. Oh, it's not the... Okay. It's not the dagger, like I thought. It is probably gonna just be unlocked by this mechanism. So I see like mountains here. This looks like wind or earth. This looks like a person. Unlock. It looks like another place. Oh. Oh, I see it. Oh. Okay. Oh, so now we can see. Oh. Is there others? Or are there others? Ooh, there is. And this one is the one with the water and the droplet. Hmm. This is neat. I like this already. We'll see if I eat my words. This is the one with the mountains. Hmm. So the sigils on the plaque represent maybe the family's representation? Or just plainly, they represent the family, perhaps? I assume that I'm unlocking them all so I can just freely walk up to these plaques and observe them, is what I'm guessing. I hope that it's not happening one at a time and I don't realize it. Okay, yeah, we're all good. This was Bartlett. We, the family Bartlett, in order to ensure our continued protection and prosperity, do enter into this holy contract with our God, accept our duties as executor of law, and willingly consign our child to be the earth in God's name. Okay, earth. We, the family shepherd, in order to ensure our continued protection and prosperity, do enter into this holy contract with our God, accept our duties as master of arms, and willingly consign our child to the water in God's name. We, the family Fitch, in order to ensure our continued protection, accept our duties as performer of rites, and willingly consign our child to the knife in God's name. So even though this is a child, it is a knife, but I guess it's a little bit of both. And then this one, Holloway. We, the family of Holloway, accept our duties as keeper of lore and willingly consign our child to the noose. Okay. So the symbols are slightly off from what we interpret as like earth. That looks like earth, but those look like mountains. And then this, it said water, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, water, so that looks right. Then this does not look like a dagger to me, or a knife to me. But that's, I guess, what it's supposed to represent. And then this is the noose. Weird that there's a dagger and a noose and water and earth. Like, I was over here thinking it was going to be like earth, air, fire, water. But it's not. Interesting. Okay, so now that we have seen the plaques on the wall. Okay. So maybe we need to have these match not the halo of the sun itself, but I guess with the houses on the right sides. This would be oh, I see it up there. Look. There it is. Shepherd. It's the one with the pitchfork. It's like the demonic rune I was thinking of in the halo of the sun. Which is, where is it? It's right here. This one right here, the outer ring. So maybe this one should be on the shepherd's side. Is it duplicated? It is. Look, there's another one right here. Okay, well, I'm gonna guess that it needs to be on our side. What I don't understand is... Oh, okay, that checks out. Look, I see it. It's like blood or something down in there. Okay. Well, then I guess this represents... It's a prescription pad from Dr. Fitch. He must have stood here during the last ritual. Okay, if Fitch was standing there, that sign is the noose related to the Holloway family. That sign, anyway. See, if we go over, so okay. Shepherd family is like, see the symbol with the pitchfork and the water? And then the, not the Bartlett, I'm looking for the Holloway. Yeah, Holloway, okay. See, that's supposed to represent, I guess, the noose. But I'm not really sure what that is supposed to be. But if you look, they've got the scales, which makes sense. The judges, they're the keepers of the lore. And then we've got the Fitch family with the eye, the all-seeing eye of God. And then the knife with this symbol. Okay, okay. So now I need to really look at Bartlett. I haven't looked at that one so far. Now that symbol, I actually don't know what that one is, and I'm not sure if that one's in the halo of the sun or not. But they consign their child to earth, and then I see these like mountains, and then that sigil. Okay, so now that I've kind of correlated what's supposed to go where, like I think, and I'm not sure, let's see how these rings move. So it looks like I can turn the inner ring and the outer ring. And where am I standing? I'm standing... Okay. The shepherd family is essentially this one marked with Fitch, which is marked by his prescription pills there, or whatever. That's gonna throw me for a loop, but I guess it helps us remember when this turns. Okay. Well, right now, just by looking at this, this is correct, technically. The scales with this symbol. That's technically correct. But if you look here on the left, these are wrong. That's a sigil or symbol representing the Shepherd family, and this one represents the Fitch family. So that's why that's wrong. This one's wrong because that's the Bartlett family's representative, like, symbol. And that one belongs to the Fitch family. So, if we turn the inner ring, I think that would be best. Actually, no, let's turn the outer ring because it's the wrong symbol for the house that's beside of me, which is mine, which is the Shepherd family. So let's move it here. That's the outer ring is now, let me see, the Fitch family. Outer ring is not correct. We need to get this one then all the way over, but then if we do that, I'm not sure if that's actually gonna do it, if that's actually gonna solve anything. Well, this is gonna be a while. Two more to go. Hopefully it's right to start in the outer ring first. I mean, if it's not, then, you know, we'll just take the time to spin it all back. But okay, this makes sense to me because now look. This is the Shepherd's representation. This is representation of Fitch. This is a representation of, let's see. Hold up. I might be wrong. That one's the Holloway family. I mean, it's close. Does that count? It's close. And then what about Bartlett? Come on, be right. Sure. I mean, it's here. Look. Close enough, right? It's off-center, like the way the family Holloway's is. Alright, I'm gonna trust it. Okay, so then now the inner ring. We already know it's wrong. That's still wrong. We need... Hey, the symbol that I'm looking for is not... It's not here. Wait. Yeah, it is. But I thought the Bartlett family... Hold on. Oh no, I'm getting it... Oh yeah, I'm right, look. See that? That goes with, I'm not sure, goes with the Bartlett family. So that can't be right with mine. Okay, hold up. I'm getting to the bottom of it. Okay, and then this one. Maybe they don't go with the families then. Maybe they just need to be there to line up. Okay, I'm gonna do that then. So then this one would be, yeah, that's correct. And then this one would be... Oh, see? That's what I'm looking for. See, look! I'm right. It's not... It doesn't exist. Look. That water symbol is nowhere to be found on the inner ring. Okay, so what this tells me is... Boot it from my mind. Because... And here's the variable... Is Dr. Fitch's prescription stuff here? He said prescription pad. He must associate during the last ritual. So this makes me think that that spot needs to be reserved for him. And it doesn't move. That particular spot. Look. See? It doesn't move. Only the inside moves. So if we turn the inner ring to be representative of a symbol that goes with the Fitch family, I mean, I guess because he was standing there, I don't know. It's either this one, that is the symbol, right? So it's either this one or that one. And it's not, this isn't, these aren't correct, I guess. I don't know for sure. Let's go see what the door says. Oh, it would unlock immediately, I think. I don't think I need to. Okay, so let's turn the inner ring again. Let's bring that other symbol down to where Fitch was standing. All right, so one more. This is so fun though. I love stuff like this. Okay. That's what I think. Now, what does this mean as far as the rest? And that's the only thing throwing me off, by the way. The prescription pad for Dr. Fitch. That is the only variable in this whole thing. Otherwise, we could just line the sucker up and be done. But it, one of the symbols does not exist on the board, this one. So that's why I feel thrown off here. So I feel like that's got to be right. So then the outer ring. So then we would change. Let's bring the eye over that goes with the Fitch family. It could be one or the other. Yes! So the prescription pad was like a base to kind of keep you organized, I guess. Oh my god, this is so cool. There's another one. Ooh. Bring it on, baby. Alright, cool. Alright, similar mechanics. We have an inner ring and outer ring. And we've got to figure out how they correlate and why. Okay, well, I see right away we've got our symbol of the water back. Okay, and that correlates, and I'm not sure if it's in the right position, but I'm going to start there. And that correlates with this symbol. Oh my god, that was like so easy. Okay. And the only reason I thought that was because it was missing from this one. So it just kind of makes sense that my family would be the answer for that door here. I don't know, but it made sense to me. Holy crap. Whoa. I've loved every bit of this, though. They've done jump scares really well, like with just when you're actually walking and trying to maneuver through the layout of the map. When the monsters would come in and scare you, I think that was done really well. The build-up, like the story, I think, the pacing of the story was done pretty well. And I wasn't really, really sure of anything up until now. Even though I had a good guess, that doesn't mean it was very obvious. Which I like. Ooh. This is a sacrificial altar for the Fitch family. This must be the altar where Dr. Fitch put Scarlet after he dismembered her. He dismembered her? So he like cut her up? Oh my god. There are four names on this plaque. So these must be all of the kids through the families, like the generations. Bartlett's sacrificial altar. This must be where Mayor Bartlett laid Joey's dead body after he buried him. Yeah, he buried him alive. This plaque has four names written on it. Oh my god. Oh god, this is gonna be it. This is what we're gonna learn. This is the shepherd's sacrificial altar. There are four names written on the plaque. It doesn't tell us. Remember, Alex, remember. My name's on there. It just clicked. It just clicked. I can't comprehend things sometimes. What?
What's the matter?
Get dressed.
Oh my god, please don't make me cry.
What are you doing here, Alex? That freak if he finds out.
Give that to me. Someone will see us.
No!
It's okay. I'm not gonna let anything happen to you.
I don't like where this is headed.
Why are we here, Alex? What's going on?
What's the matter? You scared?
Oh no, I'm cool. It's just... Dad never lets us out on the lake.
Not you, anyway. Dad thinks you're a little baby who can't do anything on his own.
Oh, yeah? Then why'd he give me this?
What is that?
It's Dad's ring. But he told me not to show you, so I guess that makes me cooler.
Let me see it.
No!
What a piece of crap.
It's not. It's worth more than $1 million. That's why Dad gave it to me. Give that back!
Supposed to be. I chose you. Now you've ruined it for all of us.
No. No, he's okay. He's right. He's like. No. No. I can save him. He's okay.
The watch. Oh my god, so he's been gone this whole time? And he's been dead this whole time, and his mom, that's why she's so zooted, because she doesn't know how to handle all this. So Alex did this, went cuckoo, lost his mind. It's coming for me now, because I need to pay for what I've done. Oh my god, Alex. How are you gonna get yourself out of this one, bud? Oh my god, I liked Alex so much. I mean, he didn't do it on purpose, I could tell. He was very, just trying to have a good time with his brother, I think. All right, sorry I'm talking so much. I'm just excited. Oh my god. What am I looking at? Is that a pregnant thing, woman, beast, monster? Why is it pregnant? And with the blades, what's up with the blades? Is this like my monster? I don't know why this is, oh my god, dude. Okay, I'm gonna stop talking. One shot left. Oof. I'm gonna make it count. Oof. All right, I gotta stop getting hit. Seriously, I'm stunlocked. All right, that's not my fault. Can I go under? All right, that's it. That's all I got. Oof. crap. Totally missed. I'm getting throwed a little bit. Just a little. Yeesh. Let's get out of this. Is there any items in the corners? Nope. It's just me and this abomination. I want to know what it means. Holy crap. We're piping this thing, man. And in not a good way. I gotta get in there. Oh, come on. This has gotta be possible. Alright, get in there, Alex. Okay. Get up. Come on. This is not cool! I'm quite literally stunlocked. Come on, stop giving me the freaking WWE treatment. Oh my god. Alright, this is sufficient. I'm getting in there. Oh, come on. It's gotta be close. I can't even... I'm trying to get in there, but it's not letting me. Maybe I just hit its arms? I don't think it can be killed with the pipe. Oh, here we go, here we go. Yikes. Come on. Oh my gosh, this is kind of ridiculous. Get in there, Alex. Come on, roll. Come on, you're almost there. There we go. Oh my gosh, that was so hard. He's like walking. Ouch. Oh, I think I got it. Oh no. This is only phase two. Holy crap. This is crazy. Yikes. Roll. Get out of that, Alex. Get out. Roll backwards. He's not doing it. All right. I'm really trying. Oh no, it's too high. I need this shotgun so bad, dude. Oh no. Yeah, this is gonna be tough. Okay. Heal. I am getting brutalized. What's this over here? Nothing. Alright, I got this. Ay. Get up, Alex, get up. Oh, it's stuck. Get in there. Hold it. Okay, pretty good. Let's get out of here. Oh, it's stuck again. Alright, let's have it do that again. Whew. I'm just gonna see if it lands that again, and then I will beat it. Oh, here we go, here we go. Go, 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 go. Got it. No problem. And again? Whew. I'm figuring it out. Lordy. Ouch. Ouch. Really hate that they could swap you out of a dodge roll. Oh, it's stuck. Come on. Oh, it got me. Uh-oh. Get up, get up, get up. Oh, no. Oh, here we go, here we go. Oh, 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 here we go, here we go. Alex? Woo. Big hits, big hits. I'm out, I'm out. Woo. It's stuck, come on. And again? Get in there, get in there. Okay, it's open. Come on. Get out of there. Get in there, get in there. Oh, thank God. Yes. Wait, how is this possible? He was inside? Oh no, can we save him? No, I'm just kind of, I guess he's repenting in a way. I don't know if he's alive or not.
Never meant for this to happen.
Oh, stop it. Gonna make me cry.
Here, buddy.
Sorry. my god, what? No way, we're back at the beginning, right? 206. Am I supposed to know what that means? The lobotomy!
What are you doing? Was this a dream? Is Joshua okay?
It's not working.
I didn't go anywhere?
No, Alex. And you won't be going anywhere until you can start to accept reality and responsibility.
No. Please don't!
Shock therapy? Oh yeah, that's what we read about. Oh my god, I beat it. You've unlocked the ER Alex costume. Yes, I would like to save my game. Was that the ending? Oh my god, that was the end. Okay, I really want to see the other endings. I enjoyed this game. I really truly think that I came into it thinking of it as such an underdog that I was already sort of like prepared in a way for like some clunky things and, you know, because it doesn't have the best reputation, let's be real. But I mean, honestly, I liked it. I think that we're supposed to see these games as like an anthology series. It's a weird anthology. Like, it's not completely like an anthology, but I call it that because it uses like the same elements but a different cast, different protagonists, different antagonists, but using kind of the same thematic elements and everything. So I kind of came into this, basically what I'm trying to say is I came at this game with a bit of grace. I thought the monster designs were done really well, like all the bosses. Now, the whole boogeyman thing, I'm probably on that side of the fandom that's I'm like, I don't know if I, you know, so, but that's all I'm gonna say, because I still really enjoyed this. But anyway, I think the monster design was really good. I think that the development team that took this on really, really tried. I think that, I'm not saying that they tried and failed. I'm just saying that I think they put in a ton of effort to preserve the spirit, the nature, the story. They even like went as far as like giving a backstory to a whole new town to describe a bit of Silent Hill's influences, I guess, on the neighboring town, you know? But I thought it was like handled creatively. I think they really tried. And again, I don't want to say tried. I think that sounds like they failed. So I'm not trying to say that. I'm just trying to say they respected, that's a better way to put it. They respected the nature of Silent Hill, really. And though it wasn't as like cryptic and like mysterious as Silent Hill 1 was, like, you know, think about Dahlia leading us these fake breadcrumbs, you know, just saying stuff that didn't make any sense, leading us astray off of our, you know, intended path on purpose. I feel like Judge Holloway didn't do that. She parallels in the opposite way, where she told us exactly what was going down, the exact plot line. And unless you guys can shed some more light on something I don't know and I haven't thought of or I didn't see or understand the same way you did, please share it below, because I like hearing what you guys have to say about this stuff, because like you, I love this story, these stories, and everything that goes with it, like the elements and the music, the creepiness, like all of it. And I mean, sure, I can be convinced of anything, like almost, if someone can explain why this was so hated and why it was so beat up and kind of treated like, I don't know. I definitely think there are some clunky things about it. I think that they tried to project it in that era of gaming when this game came out. It was when, you know, the exhilaration of combat was at its peak in gaming, and QTEs especially. So yes, Silent Hill's not supposed to have QTEs, you know, if you think of Silent Hill 1 through, you know, 3, or and 4 actually. So I can see where, all I'm trying to say, in short, I can see where the problems and inconsistencies and issues might lie. I will say that I have more grace with this game than I think the majority of fans. I'd say I lie on the line of grace, because I see a lot of care that they put into some of the puzzles. Didn't make sense, but some were just fun. Like, you know, even though that crest that I got stuck on forever, oh, there we go. There's my light. It went out. I swear this happens at the end of every playthrough, every like episode 10 or episode 9 or whatever it is on my channel. That's like the last one of the series. It's like light out at the very end. Anyway, but another thought I had was the combat being that heavy, and I might have mentioned this earlier or another part of the episodes, I'm not sure. The combat being that heavy, not even just the sheer essence or numbers of enemies you're fighting, but the emphasis rather, and the action-oriented appeal or approach to it. Like I said, I think it came from that era of gaming, and so I kind of see the developers are trying to compete with other games coming out around that time. So I can see why they did that, but I don't agree with it. Like, in essence, I think Silent Hill does not necessarily need to be that combat heavy. I mean, yeah, sure, we're like piping nurses. Not like that, but you know what I mean. Like, we're freaking throwing down nurses in Silent Hill 1 in Alchemilla Hospital like no one's business. So for that, I give it some grace. When we were doing that puzzle that I thought was going to be the Halo of the Sun, I think that was a missed opportunity. That would have been really cool because it could have described some parts of the Halo of the Sun to us without needing an analytical video, you know? And they sort of just used it to sort of show that each house was like representative of something, like a node, so to speak, of the cult. So if I had learned a little bit more about what Earth means, right? That was the Shepherd's, I guess, consignment. If I understood what, like, the knife meant for the Fitch's family, or the, you know what I'm saying, that would have been really cool. So I think that was like a little bit of a missed opportunity. And if I think hard back on the weeks that we've been playing this, I'm sure I could think of some others. But overall, I enjoyed this game. I would play it again because I want to see another ending. Because that ending, you know, before we saw what happened to poor Alex, like the shock therapy, I think there's got to be more than that. And before I had seen that and we saw that tender moment with him and his brother, I thought that was done really well. Like, I was really trying not to cry. And I really like Alex. I don't think he meant to hurt his brother. I think it was a true terrible accident, even though he did seem a little sinister. But I think he was just teasing his brother because he might be a little jealous. I mean, his family's like shunning him the whole time. Anyway, I'm going on too long about this. I really hope I'm not missing any key components or elements from the story that I maybe misinterpreted. If I did, let me know. I like to hear it all. I like to hear everything you guys have to say. And I'm just... So what about Elle, though? That's why I need to see all the other endings, because maybe there's a world where we live happily ever after with Elle, and Deputy Wheeler and my dad aren't lobotomizing me or shock therapying me. I have a feeling that hurting Miss Shepherd caused this, and I kind of want to go back. I kind of do want to go back. Maybe I will. Let's do it in another episode. What do y'all say? Anyway, I had a lot of fun with this game, and I hope that y'all enjoyed watching it as much as I enjoyed playing it. Anyway, thank y'all all so much for watching. Next up on the horizon is Shattered Memories. I've been getting that requested a lot, so I have a feeling you guys are going to be really excited for that one. And I am too. And on top of that, we're doing other things like Resident Evil stuff. That's always going to probably be going on the channel because I want to play mods. And Rebirth is continuously going on in the background. That's going to take forever. But I know all of you here probably aren't interested in Rebirth, and that's totally okay. It's just a special game to me. So you'll be seeing that coming on the channel as well. But anyway, I'm blabbering on way too much. I just had a lot of fun, and I wanted you guys to know that. Sorry my light went out. Anyway, thank y'all so much for watching this series, and let me know if you want me to, like, go back and do anything, if you want to see something, because I think I might play this again. And I want to play Silent Hill 4 again, too. As well as, like, the other games. Eventually. I just gotta figure out what kind of, how I want to play it, or if I want to play hard mode, or something like that, you know? I am not playing Homecoming on hard mode. I'm telling y'all that right now. Anyway, thank y'all so much for watching. I hope y'all have a great rest of your day or night, and I will catch you on the next one. Ciao!